Hi everyone, this is Praveena. Today I'm going to share about mathematics. Why math is important to our everyday life? Yes, it's very important to in our day-to-day life. So mathematics is a universal language. Wherever you are, wherever you are going, the math language is same to everybody. So math is part of everyone's life. So math is applied to economics, engineering, and then accountancy, and business people is also is using maths every day. So maths is your tonic of your mind. It will help you to learn new things, new methods, and new solving puzzles in the easiest way. So love the subject, then the subjects definitely will love you. Create your interest yourself, so then only you can learn maths easily. So have a fun and be happy to all the time when you are learning maths. Then only you can learn. Okay guys, let's move on to that topics. Today I'm going to take a maths class for grade 8, chapter 1, rational numbers. Today we're going to give an introductions part alone today. From this video, I'm going to give an introduction part of rational numbers. Let me move on to that topic.
Dear students, now I'm going to take a maths class for grade 8. The first chapter is rational numbers. So dear students, watch the full video and observe it and understand it. If you have any doubts, please note the doubts, and when you are coming to the class, you can ask the doubts. I will clarify your doubts. Okay. Rational numbers. Before move on to rational numbers, first let me know what is numbers and types of numbers. So these are the types of numbers: natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, rational numbers, irrational numbers, prime numbers, and composite numbers. So these are the types of numbers. So from these numbers, now I'm going to give a detail about rational number alone. So before rational numbers, let me know the numbers, rational, natural numbers. Is it used to counting the objects? It is denoted as n. The n, it is started from 1, 2, 3, etc. The whole number, it's all natural numbers with 0 is called whole numbers. It is denoted as w. It is 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. An integer is nothing but a set of numbers that includes whole number and positive, negative numbers. That is denoted as z. So z, it's formation of all negative, positive with the whole number 0. So 0 right side of all positive numbers, 0 left side is all negative numbers. So then what is rational number? Rational number is a collection of all numbers. What is meaning of all numbers? It is nothing but whole number, integers, and natural numbers. It can be any numbers. That can be written in the form of A by B, where A and B be the integers and B does not equal to 0. It is denoted as Q. So A refers as numerator and B refers as denominator. Let me see some example of rational number. So these are the examples of rational numbers. We can create any numbers like this. 4 by 5, 7 by 8, 1 by 2, like that. And next, mixed numbers also a rational numbers, like the mixed fraction is unit number with proper fraction. So 4 is a unit number, 1 by 2 is a proper fractions. This is called a mixed fraction numbers. And one more number is I'm giving 7, 3 by 4. So 7 is a unit number and 3 by 4 is a improper number. It is proper number. So I'm giving example how we convert the mixed numbers into normal fraction, that is rational numbers. So here 4, 1 by 2. So the denominator 2 is multiplied with the unit number 4. So 4 twos are, it is 8. And the numerator 1, that is your remainder part. So that should be added to that number. So 4 twos are 8 plus 1 by denominator is 2. So now 9 by 2. So the mixed fraction is changed into the rational number. So 9 by 2 is your improper fractions. So this is how you have to change your mixed fraction to normal rational numbers. And next, all integers, fractions and decimals are also can be written in the form of rational numbers. So here also I am giving example for that. 2, 3, minus 9 can be written in the form of 2 by 1, 3 by 1 and 9 by minus 9 by 1. And the decimal, I said the decimal is also can be written in the form of rational numbers. For that, I am giving two examples here. 0.25. After the decimal point, you should not read 25. So you have to read in digit wise. 0.25. So after the decimal point, you have to check how many digits are there. Here it is 2 digits. So after the decimal point, you have to say that tens, hundreds. So here we have 2 digits. So this 0.25 is divided by 100. So 25 by 100, let me simplify with 5 table, 25 table, or you can, if you order, you can simplify with 5 table, and in this is your simplest form 1 by 4. Further, we can't simplify this 1 by 4, so 1 by 4 is your rational numbers. And one more example, 0.888. So after the decimal point, you have 3 digits number. So tens, hundred, thousand. So this number should be divided by 1000. So simplify this. So we can get 111 by 125. Further, we can't simplify this. This is your standard form of your rational number. So next, ratio. The word ratio is refers to comparison of the size of the two different quantities. The ratio is nothing but to comparing two objects or two measurements or two. So two is very important. Ratio is refers to comparison of two objects. So ratios also can be written in the form of fractions. Here I am shown on the screen 1 is to 20. It is written in the form of 1 by 20. So next, let us see how to mark rational number on the number line. In the first number line, I am marking all integers on the number line. It is easy. And same way, we can mark the rational numbers is also on the number line. So all proper fraction. So next number line, I am giving marked 0, 1, in between 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 is your proper fraction. So always all the proper fractions are in between 0 and 1. You can check any numbers. So next, from this number line, I'm going to find 3 by 4. So look at here, 3 by 4 is your proper fraction and improper. First, you have to identify is it proper or improper. The denominator is greater than the numerator. So this is proper fractions. So obviously this proper fractions in between 0 and 1. So let me find how to mark this number line. It's 3 by 4. We can take 0 after is 1 by 4, 2 by 4, 3 by 4 and 4 by 4. That is your 1. So now we can easily find out that 3 by 4 in the number line is, this is your 3 by 4. So this is how you have to find the proper fractions. If it is proper fractions is given, you have to mark the number. Next, I'm going to give one more examples. Is it 5 by 6? So we are going to mark in the number line. So I'm drawing the number line. So it is, first you have to check 5 by 6, is it proper or improper? So denominator is greater than the numerator. So it is obviously is a proper fraction. So this number should be in 0 to 1. So 5, the denominator is 6, so we can take 1 by 6, like that, 1 by 6, 2 by 6, 3 by 6, 4 by 6, 5 by 6, and the last one is 6 by 6, that is your 1. So now we can find easily where is 5 by 6 is. Yes, here is your fraction number 5 by 6. This is how you have to mark the number line. Okay, dear students. So we will see to the next class. Hope you understand this topics, rational numbers and how to mark the number line. So let me see it in the next class. Thank you so much and bye bye. Take care.